forecast with meteorologist Mike Hurd.
Colder than normal temperatures are likely to continue for the next 5 days for the Butte area, but we'll try and get back up in that upper 50 range by the time we get into Wednesday and Thursday of next week. But it's just a slow progression. Tomorrow's going to be one of the coldest days, and then we try and bump those numbers up slightly as we get into the weekend early next week. For Bozeman, right around 60, 62 degrees is normal, and we'll get close to that by Wednesday and Thursday of next week. But again, it's a slow process. We're stuck with this weather pattern because everything is moving extremely slow from west to east across the country. And the reason is we've got a big ridge of high pressure on the west coast. Got this deep trough that moved through here just 24 hours ago. And then another big ridge out here across the northeastern United States. So with the jet stream, it's highly amplified, big kinks and curves. Everything slows way down. So this upper level low is actually expected to stay across North and South Dakota for another 48 to 72 hours. But it's this ridge pattern that's keeping things pretty quiet across Montana, but keeping temperatures colder than normal for the next several days. Now, the pattern does change a little bit by the time we get into Sunday. We'll start to bring in a southwest flow as the high gets squashed down to the south a little bit and an approaching cold front, which may drive a little bit of wet weather in here Sunday night into Monday morning and maybe even Monday night into Tuesday morning. But it's not expected to be a widespread event, just a few nuisance showers. So you look outside right now, crystal clear skies in Butte. We're sitting at 29 degrees. That was the max today. And in fact, that's where we should be pretty much for an overnight low temperature, normally around 28. 12, though, was a starting point this morning. Bozeman, again, abundant sunshine this afternoon and extremely icy this morning. Roads have thawed out, thankfully, with a little bit of sunshine. We're holding at 30 degrees. The max temperature just barely hit 32 this afternoon for a short period of time. Right now, temperatures are mixed, mostly in 20s and 30s. There is slightly milder numbers, but still cold out towards Missoula and Kalispell. They did reach the lower 40s here this afternoon. So tonight, dropping off into the single digits. Wisdom, I got you down there around 5 to 10 below zero, but single digits and teens for everyone else. Again, numerous record lows are expected tomorrow morning. Afternoon highs will slow to warm up, but we could hit the low 30s through the upper 30s tomorrow. Clear, cold, light winds. Again, most of you could see some record low temperatures tomorrow morning, falling slightly below zero again in West Yellowstone. But tomorrow, just a few degrees warmer than today. Mid 30s, maybe even some mid to upper 30s are possible. And mostly sunny skies, should be a dry weather period. Now, that dry weather trend should continue into the weekend, but will bring a slight chance for a few hit and miss showers, but it's a low probability into the first half of next week. But warmer highs and warmer lows are coming, but again, a slow process. It's going to take several days, if not a better part of a week, to get back up to where we should be. For Butte, again, quite chilly for the next couple of days, especially at night, but upper 40s and lower 50s are expected sometime next week. Down in Dillon, same type of weather pattern, well below normal for highs and lows for a couple of days, but the low 50s are likely by Tuesday, maybe even an upper 50 by Wednesday. And West Yellowstone, quite cold for the next two or three nights, only in the 30s for highs, but eventually warming up into the 40s and into the 50s. So it'll be amazing how warm it'll feel to hit 58 degrees on it.
Yeah. Bring it on. Yeah. Bring it on. Yeah. Thanks, Mike. All right, Nick Petrotoni's in with our sports, and kind of a sad day in Anaconda.
One of their legends of the sport of basketball passed away earlier this week. We'll give you the story next.